Sonny Houston at number 25, moving up fast, up 15 notches with a song from her number one album, Whitney. Didn't we almost have it all? You're listening to American Top 40 in Hollywood. I'm Casey Kasem. Well, now we're up to the song When Smokey Sings by ABC. The song pays tribute to Smokey Robinson, and it makes Smokey the fifth top 40 act to be named in the title of a top 40 hit by someone else. Interestingly, each time that happened, the act named has also been in the countdown with their own hit. That's pretty wild chart stuff. The first act named in a hit song title by someone else was a German piano player named Crazy Otto. The Crazy Otto medley by Johnny Maddox. While that was in the top 40, Crazy Otto himself also had a hit in the 40. The next act, named in a hit by someone else, were the Beatles. It was sort of a recorded fan letter. Listen to this. Carefrees. In 1964, it was in the top 40 for 1 week, while the Beatles were also in with seven of their own hits. Now, the next act, named in another act's hit, came in 1977, a song about a king. The king is gone. It was country singer Ronnie McDowell's tribute to the king of rock and roll, Elvis Presley, who died in 1977. Ironically, while that song was in the top 40, so was a posthumous hit by Elvis. In 1985, a fourth artist was named in a top 40 hit by someone else. The song wasn't a tribute, it was a complaint. Rick Springfield was being mistaken for this boss rocker. Tell anybody, ain't gonna believe it. 2 years ago, Bruce by Rick Springfield, who was mistaken for Bruce Springsteen, and it was in the survey at the same time Bruce was in. Well, now, Smokey Robinson, Motown vice president, has become the fifth artist named in someone else's hit, and guess who's also in the countdown singing his own hit? That's right, Smokey, debuting back at number 40, One Heartbeat. Now here's the song all about Smokey, at number 24, ABC, and When Smokey Sings.